844 now, starting this Friday, San Francisco will be the first major city in our country to require proof of full vaccination against COVID for indoor locations such as bars, restaurants, clubs, theaters, performance spaces, and indoor gyms. And there are signs that San Francisco and many major cities have lost some of the progress made against COVID. As we do every month, we welcome San Francisco Mayor London Breed back to Mornings on 2. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Garcia.
Of course. As the new mandate goes into effect in just days, how do you plan to enforce the vaccine mandate? I remember restaurant workers saying that it was exhausting, in some cases dangerous, when they were front and center trying to enforce masking rules.
I think this is more about education than it is about being aggressive around enforcement. We have a number of the bar owners who came out, the Bar Owners Association, and said, we need to require this because it's not only to protect other customers, it's to protect our workers. And so many of the workers that I've talked to at bars and restaurants and other places, they have expressed gratitude for this new requirement because of their real concerns about people who are dining that they're serving and the increase in the number of their employees who have contracted COVID, even though they've been vaccinated. So this is really a thing that we're not trying to be super aggressive around enforcement. We just want people to comply.
But will there be enforcement?
There will be enforcement, definitely, just like there have been enforcement throughout the pandemic around some of the requirements that we've had around mask wearing and other things and establishments and the 6 feet barriers. So we'll transition into making sure that we're checking in with businesses and that they're complying. You know, it's a tough thing that we have to do, but I will say that the good news is that about 79% of San Franciscans are fully vaccinated. Yeah. And what we're seeing is an uptick in the number of vaccines. But even over 2 days ago, we're seeing an increase in the number of people who are hospitalized. Yeah. 117 people are in the hospital. We're still seeing about 230 on average new cases a year. So this is not completely going away. And we have to implement a number of these policies so that we can get back on the right track and really reduce this curve significantly.
We're in such a different place than when we were just a couple months ago. I remember some excitement when the city closed the Embarcadero test site in June, Moscone Center vaccination site closed in July. And here we are with the city opening up a new mass testing site south of Market. Will you consider perhaps even more carefully eliminating COVID resources once we get through this latest surge?
I think everything depends on the numbers. Everything depends on the demand. And right now, the reason why we needed to open another testing site is because of a lot of people who are not insured, where their employers are required testing even when they're vaccinated, people who need a last minute test for essential workers and other things. So we want to encourage people to continue to go to their healthcare providers to get their test. And we are working with healthcare providers to make sure that they're doing it at a faster pace. But in the meantime, we need to increase our capacity for testing because of this surge, because we are seeing people who are both vaccinated and unvaccinated infected, and we want to make sure that we don't see major outbreaks.
Do you view this opening of the test site in Soma as a step back?
I don't view it as a step back. I think that what people think is, okay, we squashed the curve, it's going away. We've done this too, now we're at a third surge. And the fact is, what I've said time and time again, this is an unpredictable virus. It is mutated and come back stronger. And the fact is, it's with us, and we just have to adapt to it. We have to adapt to mask wearing and some of the requirements. We may see this virus get crushed, but it's unpredictable as to what will happen in the future. So I don't see it as a step back. I feel like we're more empowered. We know more about it. We know vaccines are effective. We know the things that we can do to help keep ourselves safe, and we got to continue to do that.
All right, let's talk about help in San Francisco for people who are homeless. The city is buying more buildings for housing for people who are homeless. Tell me, Mayor, did I read this right? 368 housing units using $400 million in local funding. That works out, by my math, to more than $1 million per unit.
Well, I think, Garcia, you have to understand it's more than just purchasing a unit. We have services and resources and rehabilitation work and other things that go into purchasing a number of these buildings. The fact is, we have, in some cases, in some of these hotels. We have people who are currently living there. We have made a commitment that everyone who has been housed in a shelter-in-place hotel will not be returned to the streets to make our homeless challenge even worse than it is now. And so our goal is to try and make sure that we have as many units as we possibly can to get people indoors and off the streets. And the good news too is we have money from the state. Project Room Key has been very helpful. We allocated about $1 billion for the next 2 years to address challenges with homelessness. And now we have to make sure we invest those resources in purchasing more housing units.
All right. San Francisco Mayor London Breed, of course, as we're talking, San Francisco school children are back in class. So again, we wish everyone a happy and healthy start to the new school year. Again, thank you for joining us. It's good to connect with you monthly.
Thank you.
Of course.